This is part 2, displaying data in ADS. And here, I'll show you how to plot and list data, how to write equations, how to differentiate between data sets, and use other data in ADS. Let's begin with the contents of a data set. Every ADS data set contains one or more of the following: variables, such as frequency, and that would be an independent variable, and maybe voltages that depend on that frequency. So we have independent and dependent. Wire labels or node voltages, so you name them in schematic and they appear in the data set. Every time you use a source, you'll see a dot I appended, and the name of that source will be in the data set with the current. Probe data, we have current probes, power probes, and other types of probes, so you'll see them in the data set. All these things come from schematic, including port impedances. When you do an S parameter simulation, you'll see those. And equations you create in schematic, not those in the data display, but from schematic. And finally, index values, and these can be things like the mix table that you'll see with harmonic balance, which has an index for all of the individual frequencies. Now, let's look at some examples. This example will create a data set we can look at: a harmonic balance simulation, which is set up to calculate the fundamental frequency of 1 GHz, and a total of 3 harmonics, which means the fundamental, the second, and the third. Here is a source, which is also a port in ADS because it has a box drawn around it and a built-in impedance, and most important, it has Z and a value for the impedance. So this can be used for S parameters, or in this case, a P one tone source where you specify the power in one tone, which is 1 GHz. We also have a DC source, and we have two wire labels or node names, VIN and VOUT, which we've labeled, and an equation which is based on these two voltages that will be in their data set, and finally a probe here that will give us current, and one last node voltage here at V diode. I'm going to run the simulation for this design, and we would expect in the data set to see frequency, the independent variable, those are the calculated frequencies from harmonic balance, the gain equation, it'll be listed there just as gain, these node voltages where the wire labels are at Vout, Vdiode, and Vin, and our source current here, along with the mix table, which gives us our indexes for harmonic balance. The simulation finishes, and it writes the data, HB data, into the data directory. And let me show you the data that's contained in this data set by inserting a list. That's an easy thing to do. And here you can see we have frequency, which is an independent variable. We have our gain equation. We have the current from that probe. We have mix, which is a table of index values. I'm going to add that. I'll also add gain to this list. Here's our source current with the dot I, and then our node names where we get the voltages at those nodes. So all this will be in our list that I've selected, and we'll click OK. And for any list that you create, simply increase the size of it. And here we can see the frequencies that were calculated: the DC component, the first, second, and third harmonic, and here's the list of index values that harmonic balance generates. Here's our complex gain for every one of these frequencies. So gain is dependent upon the frequency. So is VIN and VOUT, which is our wire labels or our node names. Now let's go back to schematic. Here back in schematic, I want to show you something else about current that you can get in the data set. You can always use a current probe, and you can see that's what we have here, and we've already shown that. But if you edit the controller, and every controller has this except for S parameter, you can select pin currents. So the default doesn't have pin current selected, but if you do select it and then run the simulation, let me show you what you'll get. Here in the data display, I simply edit the list by double clicking, and you can see now with the simulation set to include the pin currents, it has a lot more data in there. It has all of the pin currents. You simply pick one and add it, and that's what I've done, and then you can see that also added to our list. So that's how you get pin currents, by simply going to the controller and selecting it. However, with a large schematic, you may not want all of that data. So by selecting this and then going to the Add or Remove button here, you'll get a dialog that will allow you to select each individual component and the pin currents that are available. You can see that here, and then add or remove them as you need. So let's go ahead and cancel this. And now that we've seen, there are two ways to get current. One is to use the controller, all but the S parameter, of course, and select pin currents. You'll get them all unless you control it. And the other way is simply to use a current probe, and that's been a standard way for a long time. So either way works, and you can use either data on plots or in equations. Here in this next example, I simply copied the same circuit and simulation controller and saved it in a schematic, as you can see here, named DDS for Data Display SCH. So that will be our data set name. When I run the simulation with the same circuit, I'm going to get S parameter data and harmonic balance data in the same data set. Then I'm going to go back and deactivate these two controllers using the deactivate button here. And then I'll reactivate this transient simulation I've set up and rename the data set by going to Simulate and then Simulation Setup. And this is where I can name the data set that's going to be used in my same data display. As you can see, I've already done that. I have the transient, S parameter harmonic balance. So it's simply a matter of deciding which data set that you want for any given simulation. So I'm going to run the other two first, then I'll run the transient. When I run the transient, of course, then I'll have this data set name. Now, because I have this hotkeyed, you can see here it's very easy for me. All I have to do is use the S on my keyboard. It comes up, I name the data set and simulate right from this same dialog and activate and deactivate whatever I need. So now I'll run the simulations and we'll look at the data. Let's begin with the transient simulation data. I'm going to select that data set. Remember, this is the plot that pops up automatically with the default data set with the name of the schematic. And I simply select the data set that I want. And what I've done is I've selected VDiode and VOut and added them. And you can see the results here. And because they're a different data set than the default, you will see the path name that's shortened. Here it's transient underscore DDS underscore schematic. That's the name that I gave that data set, dot dot VDiode or dot dot VOut. Here's the data way to expect. And whenever you have two data sets on one plot, one of them will show you the path name or the data set name. The other one, because it's the default, won't. So to prove this, let's insert a rectangular plot. This is our default data set once again, and let's look at VOut. I'll simply add it, and I'm always prompted. It knows it's harmonic balance data. You can see that here. And so it asks how you want the value handled. DBM is fine. And now we can see the results here. DBM of VOut, and it's pointing to the default data set. And that's how you can differentiate between plots that have different data sets. Now you can have a plot with traces or spectral components from multiple data sets. So if this was also time domain, which I can transform it to, then I could add it onto this plot also. Now in the data display, there are many things you can do. For example, if you select a plot and you edit the individual spectral lines or the traces, then you can change their type. You have many options here for the color and how they're drawn. You can change the plot axes. You can have two axes, that is two y axes. So anytime you want to do that, either select the trace or simply select the plot and double click. Then you can select the trace and go to trace options, which is the same thing as double clicking on the plot. I suggest you try this on your own. It's the best way to learn. Let me show you the S parameter data next.